My dear children, how are you? I hope you are fine. In today's class, we are going to extend our ideas about the topic fractions. Already we have discussed about the concept of fractions in some chapter, I think parcel course, I think. Okay, in today's class, we are going to extend our ideas towards the topic fractions. Okay, first of all, we are going to recap the definition of fraction and its type. What is mean by fraction? Fraction is a part of a whole. The whole may be either a single object or collection of objects. What is mean by fraction? Fraction is a part of a whole. The whole may be either a single object or a collection of objects. Okay. So a fraction contains a numerator and a denominator. So the number which are in the form are said to be fractions. And what are the types of fractions we can discuss? Proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction, like fractions, unlike fractions, equal fractions. These are the types of fractions we have discussed already. Once again, we are going to recall it. What is meaning by proper fraction? The value of the numerator is less than its denominator. Then the fraction is said to be proper fraction. See here, the numerator is 4, denominator is 7. So the value of the numerator is less than its denominator. Such fractions are said to be proper fraction. Here also see the numerator 1, denominator is 3. So the numerator value is less than the value of the denominator. So this type of fractions are said to be proper fraction. Okay. Next we are going to see improper fraction. What is mean by improper fraction? If the value of numerator is greater than its denominator value. See here, value of the numerator is greater than its denominator. Such fractions are said to be improper fraction. If the value of the numerator is greater than its denominator. See here, 9 is greater than 2. Thus, the numerator is greater than its denominator. See here, 7 by 3. Numerator is greater than its denominator. See here, 6 by 4. Numerator is greater than its denominator. So, such fractions are said to be improper fraction. If numerator is smaller, it is proper fraction. If numerator is bigger, it is improper fraction. See here, it is very important fraction, mixed fraction. What is the mixed fraction? A mixed fraction contains a whole part and a proper fraction. See here, 1, 2 by 3. In this fraction, 1 is said to be whole part and 2 by 3 is said to be proper fraction. So, a whole part and a proper fraction is said to be mixed fraction. So, mixed fraction is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. See here, 2, 4 by 5. 2 is a whole number, 4 by 5 is a proper fraction. So, this is said to be mixed fraction. See here, 3, 4 by 7. Whole number, 4 by 7 is a proper fraction. So, a combination of whole number and a proper fraction is said to be mixed fraction. Do you understand, children? Next, we are going to see like fractions. Which fractions are said to be like fractions? In the given fractions, the denominators are same, then the fractions are said to be like fractions. See here, 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 5 by 7. All the denominators are equal to the value 7. So, these fractions are said to be like fractions. Okay. See the next one, unlike fractions. What is meant by unlike fractions? If the given fractions have different denominators, such fractions are said to be unlike fractions. See here, 1 by 2, 3 by 5, 7 by 9. Compare the denominators. All the denominators are different value. So, such fractions are said to be unlike fractions. Okay. Next, equivalent fractions. What is mean by equivalent fractions? Fractions have different numerator as well as different denominator, but they are equal to same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. See here, 2 by 3, which is equal to 4 by 6, which is equal 4 by 6 by 2. What you get? 2 2s are 4, 3 2s are 6. You get the value 2 by 3. Suppose if you divide this fraction by 3, what you get? 2 3s are 6, 3 3s are 9. Again you get the fraction 2 by 3. See, 2 by 3, which is equal to 2 by 3, which is equal to 2 by 3. Thus, fractions having different numerator and different denominator, but their values are equal to same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. We understand, children. These are the types of fractions we have already discussed. Okay. In today's class, what you are going to see is very important and basic concept. Listen carefully, children. Conversion of mixed fractions into improper fraction. How do you convert if the given mixed fraction as improper fraction? Suppose if mixed fraction is equal to you, how do you convert that mixed fraction into improper fraction? In today's class, we are going to see this. Okay, see here. This is the formula for writing the improper fraction from mixed fraction. Okay, see here, improper fraction is equal to 4 into denominator plus numerator, 4 divided by denominator. Once again, I am reading. Improper fraction equal to 4 into denominator plus numerator by denominator. Shortly, we can write it as, for improper, we are taking the letter first letter I, for fraction F. So, capital I dot F equal to, for whole number, we are taking the first letter W, for denominator D, and numerator N, and for denominator D, and shortly we are writing whole into denominator plus numerator by D, that is I F equal to W into D plus N by D. What is meant by W? W is said to be whole, and D is denominator, and N is numerator, D is numerator. You can easily understand this formula by doing this sum. Okay. See the first one. Write the following as improper fraction. Now we are going to convert this. What type of fraction is this? Yes, it contains a whole part and a proper fraction. So it is a mixed fraction. Now we are going to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. How we are going to convert? Listen here. Write the question once again. 2, 3 by 5. 2, 3 by 5. Which is the whole part? 2 is the whole part. So write the value 2 as the value of W. So W is equal to 2. And what is the value of denominator? 5 is the denominator. So write 5 as the denominator. And what is the numerator? 3 is the numerator. So write the values of W, D and N. W equal to 2, D equal to 5, N equal to 3. Now we are going to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now we are going to convert by using this formula. Listen carefully, children. 2, 3 by 5. How do you read this? 2, 3 by 5. Now we are going to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now we are going to convert by multiplying whole part into denominator part. Which is the whole part here? 2. And what is the denominator? 5. So here we have to write 2 into 5. Do you understand, children? Whole part into denominator. See here, whole part into denominator plus, what is the numerator? 3. So write 3 here and write the denominator. What is the denominator? 5. So by using the formula W into D plus N by D. See here, what is the value of W? Whole part 2 into, what is the value of denominator? 5. 2 into 5. 2 into 5 plus 3. 4 divided by, write the denominator as it is. Okay. Now we are going to multiply this. 2 into 5, 10 plus 3 by 5. So 5 2s are 10 plus 3 by 5. So what is the answer? 10 plus 3? 13 by 5. What type of fraction is this? Observe the value of numerator. It is bigger than its denominator. So it is an improper fraction. Thus we have converted the mixed fraction into improper fraction. See the next sum. 4 1 by 3. Now we are going to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. What is the formula for converting mixed fraction into improper fraction? W into D plus N by D. W means 4 into denominator plus numerator whole divided by denominator. Here, what is the value of W? W equal to 4. This is the whole power. What is the value of numerator? 1. This is value of N. What is the value of denominator? 3. So value of D is 3. Now we are going to find out the improper fraction of this mixed fraction 4 1 by 3. So 4 1 by 3 equal to whole power into denominator. What is the whole power? W. So 4 into 3. 4 into 3. Whole power into denominator plus numerator. So what is the numerator? 1. Whole divided by, write the denominator as it is, by 3. Do you understand, children? Whole power into denominator plus numerator. You have to write the whole part and denominator within the bracket. Okay. So 4 into 3 plus 1. You have to add this numerator after multiplying these two values. So 4 3s are 12. So 12 plus 1 by 3. So 12 plus 1, 13 by 3. Thus we have converted the mixed fraction 4 1 by 3 as improper fraction. How do you say this as an improper fraction? Because its numerator 13 is greater than its denominator. So this fraction is improper fraction. Okay. See the next one. 8 5 by 7. What is the value of W here? Value of whole power is 8. What is the value of numerator? 5. What is the value of denominator? 7. So we have written the values of W, N and D. What is the formula? IF equal to W into D plus N whole divided by D. That is whole into denominator plus numerator whole divided by D. This is the formula for writing improper fraction from mixed fraction. Okay. Thus 8 5 by 7 is equal to whole power into denominator. So 8 into 7. 8 into 7 whole power into denominator plus numerator by denominator. We understand that whole power into denominator plus numerator by D. Here whole power is 8. So 8 into what is the denominator? 7. 8 into 7 plus numerator value 5 whole divided by 7. So 8 sevens are, what is the value of 8 sevens are? 56 plus 5 by 7. So now we have to add these two values. 56 plus 5. What is the answer? 61 by 7. Obviously this is an improper fraction because the value of the numerator is greater than its denominator. Thus we have converted the mixed fraction 8 5 by 7 as improper fraction. Okay. Next we are going to see the sum 1 4 by 7. Here what is the value of whole power? 1. What is the value of numerator? 4. What is the value of denominator? 9. So by the formula you have to multiply whole power with denominator. So 1 into 9 plus numerator. So 1 into 9 plus numerator by write the denominator as it is. So 1 9 is 9 plus 4 by 9. 9 plus 4, 13 by 9. Thus we have converted the given mixed fraction into improper fraction. Okay, see the last sum. 3 1 by 9. Here what is the value of W? Whole power is 3. Numerator is 1. Denominator is
10.
So what is the formula? Whole marking denominator plus numerator by denominator. So 3 into 10. This is the whole part into denominator plus numerator by denominator. So 3 into 10, 30 plus 1 by 10. 30 plus 1, 31 by 10. Thus we have converted the given mixed fraction into improper fraction. See, 10 threes are 30, 30 plus 1, 31 by 10. Thus we have discussed the how to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Next we are going to see how to convert improper fraction to mixed fraction. See here. Here also we have formula to write the mixed fraction. Mixed fraction equal to quotient remainder by divisor. Once again take the formula. Mixed fraction equal to quotient remainder by divisor. Where you get the quotient remainder and the divisor, you can easily understand when doing the sum. Okay. Shortly we will learn this formula as for mixed. First we are taking the first letter M for fraction F. So M dot F is equal to Q R by D. Q R by D. Mixed fraction equal to Q R by D. Q for quotient, R for remainder, D for divisor. Okay. See the first sum. Write the following as mixed fraction. Subdivision A, 13 by 5. See what type of fraction is this? This is improper fraction because the value of the numerator is greater than its denominator. Now we are going to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. How we are going to convert? By dividing this numerator by its denominator. So denominator here is said to be divisor. So what is called divisor? 5 is called divisor. Now we are going to rewrite this question as 13 divided by 5. Now we are going to divide this numerator by this divisor. Now we are going to divide it 13, 5. So in 5 table, 13 comes how many times? It did not come. So what is the number before this 13? 12. 12 also not come in the 5 table. So we have 10 in the 5 table 2 times. So 2 5 are 10. By subtracting we get 3 as the remainder. So listen carefully children. This is remainder. And this is quotient. And this is divisor. May I understand? This is remainder and this is quotient and this is divisor. So what is the formula of mixed fraction? Q R by D. This is quotient remainder by divisor. What is the divisor here? 5. What is the quotient here? 2. What is the remainder here? 3. Now we are going to write the mixed fraction for this improper fraction. Now we are going to write C here. First, don't confuse children. Write the denominator first. So write the 5 here and write the remainder as the numerator. The number which is down will come in the up. So that is numerator. So write the remainder as the numerator. So write here 3 and write the quotient as a whole part. So 2. Do you understand children how we are writing quotient remainder by divisor? So what is the quotient here? 2. So write the 2 here. And what is the remainder here? 3. And what is the divisor here? 5. So our answer is the mixed fraction for improper fraction 13 by 5 is 2, 3 by 5. Let us check our answer is right or wrong. 2 5s are 10. 10 plus 3, 13 by 5. Thus we got the question. I hope you all understand this. See the solution B, 14 by 3. See here, an improper fraction. Now we are going to convert this improper into mixed fraction. What is the formula for mixed fraction? Mixed fraction equal to quotient remainder by divisor. What is the divisor? Denominator is said to be divisor. So once again in the solution part you have to write the question and you have to rewrite it as 14 divided by 3. Now we are going to divide the 14 by 3 in order to get the mixed fraction. So in the rough work definitely you have to show this division. Okay. So in three table 14 comes how many times? 14 did not come. So you have to check for the digit also mark out. So 12. So 12 comes in three table 4 times. 4 3 is 12. By subtracting 12 from 14, you get 2 as the remainder. So remainder is 2. Divisor is 3. Quotient is 4. Thus we have found out the value of Q, R and D. Now we are going to rewrite this. Now we are going to write this improper fraction as mixed fraction by using the value of quotient as a whole mark and remainder as the numerator and denominator as denominator. Denominator is said to be divisor also. So 14 by 3 equal to 4, 2 by 3. Now we are going to check the answer. 4 3 is 12. 12 plus 2, 14 by 3. Thus our answer is correct. See the next sum, 19 by 2. So once again in the solution form we have to write the question and rewriting as 19 divided by 2. In the rough form you have to divide the 19 by 2. In 2 table 19 did not come. So the previous number 18. 9 to 18. So by subtracting 18 from 19, your remainder is 1. So value of R is 1, value of Q is 9 and value of D is 2. So by using the formula mixed fraction equal to QR by 3, we are going to write the mixed fraction of 19 by 2 as, write the divisor as it is. And the remainder became the numerator and the quotient became the whole part. Thus, the mixed fraction of this improper fraction is 9 1 by 2. See here children, now we are going to check our answer is correct or not. So, whole part into denominator plus numerator by denominator. 9 2 is 18, 18 plus 1. 19 by 2. Thus we got the question. Thus our answer is correct. So this is the way you have to check whether your answer is correct or not. Okay. See the next one. 86 by 10. We rewrite it as 86 divided by 10. What is the formula for mixed fraction? Q R by D. So by dividing the given number, we are going to found the Q R by D. So 86 divided by 10. Our divisor is 10, which is a 2 digit number. So 1 digit is not enough. So you have to take 2 digits. So take the number 86 as it is. So 8 tens are 80. So by subtracting here, 6 is the remainder. So what is the value of R? 6. What is the value of Q? 8. What is the value of D? 10. Thus we have found out the value of D, Q and R. What is the form of our mixed fraction? Mixed fraction equal to Q, R by D. Now we are going to substitute the value of this. Okay. What is the question? 86 by 10. What is the value of Q? 8. What is the value of R? 6. What is the value of D? 10. Write the denominator as it is. And the remainder became the numerator. And quotient became the whole part. Okay, do you understand? See the next sum. 15 by 6. Rewrite it as 15 divided by 6. Now we are going to rewrite it as a mixed fraction. For that, we have to find the value of Q, R and D. So we are dividing 15 by 6. 1 6 is 6, 2 6 are 12, 3 6 are 18. So here you have to write 2 6 are 12. So by subtracting, getting 3 as the remainder. So value of R is 3, value of Q is 2, value of D is R. Now we know the formula mixed fraction equal to Q R by D. Here our improper fraction is 5 by 6. This 5 by 6 equal to write the divisor as it is. Do you understand children? Write the divisor as it is and write the remainder as the numerator and write the quotient as the whole part. Do you understand? Thus the mixed fraction of given improper fraction is 2 3 by 6. 6 are 12, 12 plus 3, 15 by 6. Thus, in today's class, we have discussed how to convert different fraction into improper fraction and improper fraction into mixed fraction. Also, we have recalled types of fractions definition also. Okay, write your class up very neatly and do your homework in homework note. Okay, thank you, children.